What comes to mind when you think of pure brute strength? I'm talking in the real world, in video games, whatever. I know that one of the first things that comes to mind for me is a giant ogre-like or cyclops creature with a giant maul or hammer in its hands. In Monster Hunter World, and all of the Monster Hunter series, the monster you face towers over you with ease in most cases. What is more satisfying than taking that beast to the ground with your sheer amount of strength? We aren't firing any fancy arrows, we're not shooting explosive shells or ammo, just the weapon in our hands and the might we put behind each swing. It takes a courageous breed to take up this weapon and head out on the hunt. Just remember one thing and there won't be any problems. The head is mine. Let me tell you why I love the hammer. One of the very first things that I love when it comes to the hammer is that you really aren't bound to any skills. I mean, of course, you want to get your usual DPS skills in there like crit eye, crit boost, and weakness exploit. But from there, it's truly whatever you want to make it. I know for myself, I ran with quite a few differentiating sets, and I didn't really notice any of them severely lacking behind the other. Like I said earlier though, the DPS skills were all consistent and maxed out for each. At one point when I was kicking off the rust, I gave myself some added cushion by throwing in some medicine or recovery up. Once I got back into the swing of things, I started to play around with different skills. If you want to throw on some more attack, you can play around with agitator or peak performance, or you could go down a little less traveled path and throw on some coalescence and a couple points of resistor. Even throwing on a few points of attack boost is an option for that extra affinity. I know for myself, I probably enjoyed using evade extender the most, but I'm pretty biased when it comes to that skill. I love how much it vastly improves your mobility, and with a weapon like hammer that loses its charge when you sheath it, having improved mobility can help you from having to do that very often. But there is one skill that seems to draw ire from people in the community when you use it, and hammer is a weapon that it's typically connected to. Slugger. I'm of the perspective if you want to throw Slugger on your build, do it, and don't feel bad doing it. You play the way you want to play, and if having a little extra KO damage makes you happy, then that's all that matters. Now in saying that, if you're looking to min-max or meta chase, then obviously you don't want to go down in that direction. We haven't even talked about things like Partbreaker or other skills, which clearly shows just how flexible you can be when building for the hammer, and just how specific you can be when building towards your playstyle. If you're looking to just go out and smack things around without having to worry about finding a way to put this or that into your build, you found yourself a winning weapon. I'm by no means a hammer expert, but the build that I used the most consisted of everyone's favorite go-to combo of the Teostra head, hands, and waist, and the Brute Tigrix chest, and the God-tier Garuga legs. From there, we go ahead and max out our usual DPS skills, crit eye, crit boost, and weakness exploit. I wanted to go ahead and get that mobility that I talked about earlier, so evade extender is also maxed out, and thanks to a few jumping slash attack combo decos, I was able to get attack boost to level 4 for that final 5% affinity to get us to 100% affinity on weakened parts. When it comes to my Saffy weapon, I just went literally straight up attack. Hammer isn't something that has a hard time keeping up sharpness, and you combine this with the fact that we have Master's Touch, so we're good on that front and don't have to feel guilty throwing in that extra bit of attack. I also decided to use a Blast Hammer, mainly because of all the Saffy weapons outside of the Hunting Horn that I grabbed, they're all blast weapons. The first highlight of the hammer itself that makes me enjoy playing it is the attack variety. Depending on what level you charge the hammer up to, it will do a different attack and you'll be able to do a different combo. This ranges from a wide swinging combo, an uppercut, a powerful swirling smash, spinning the hammer in a circle and finishing with a huge swing. It's a good variety that is quickly accessible no matter what the situation is. You can throw on levels of the skill focus to bring down the amount of time to get through your charge levels, but for me, I like to leave focus off entirely so I have better control of which level I want to land on and release for an attack. It's something you'll start to get more used to, and honestly, it'll start to become second nature pretty quickly. Do you have time to charge all the way up and do a powerful spinning smash? Or is that opening starting to close? If that opening is closing quicker than expected, then you can let the attack go off early and get a quick uppercut right into the monster's dome. Outside of those moves where you can go through the various levels of charge, there's another high damaging combo that ends with a very high damage slam at the end. This combo is typically used when the monster is down, but when you get through the combo and land that final hit, boy, you'll be satisfied with the damage done. But that's not the end of damage dealing options that the hammer has. There's a specific area of territory that the hammer can really shine. When it comes to hills, the hammer is definitely the king. If you're charging up and start to head down an incline, you set yourself up to do an absolute crazy amount of damage. You launch yourself up into the air and become a spinning wheel of pain, doing damage with every bit of contact your hammer does, and then you end that with a pulverizing slam that does a huge chunk of damage. It's a quick and easy move to land. You only need a slight understanding of the monster's moves to know exactly whether or not you'll be able to pull off a full spin. It can be a little difficult landing that final hit exactly where you want it to, but with a bit of practice, you'll be able to pinpoint where you want that final swing to hit. Not only are you going to notice just how much damage you're doing, you're going to notice that it's an absolute breeze mounting monsters when you have access to a hill. More mounts mean more monsters flat on the ground, just waiting to be bonked with your hammer. There are quite a few weapons that get some extra love when it comes to hills and sliding attacks, but none of them are as seamless and easy to pull off as the hammer. Not only that, but the amount of bang for your buck that you get out of this spinning barrage is heavily in your favor. When you think KO, you think the hammer, and for good reason. Now, don't think I'm trying to say that no other weapon comes close or that no other weapon is good for KOs. I'm a hunting horn main, so I know that other weapons are capable at being solid with knockouts. But if we're honest, the first weapon that's going to come to mind is the hammer. It's just so KO potent. Every single swing has that feel and weight to it that it could potentially bring the monster to the floor, even the smaller hits in between in the combos. But then once you get to some of the heavier hits, it is unmatched in how gratifying it is to send a monster flinching across the way after sending a swing right to its jaw. But we're not satisfied with just a simple flinch. Just wait and see how many times you'll be seeing stars around the monster's head after you get that home run connection. Earlier I talked about the spin from the hills, and the amount of knockouts I've had result from that is incredible. And it's not just the final slam at the end of your spin, it's every single one of those swings in between that also have the potential to take the monster out. That versatility in available attacks also comes back into play. Monsters have specific openings that you have to take advantage of, and those openings can vary quite a bit. Some attacks leave monsters recovering for a moment, some they bounce right back from. You can take advantage of any of these openings with the different charge attacks and build up that KO quickly. The hammer is good at dishing out damage, and that damage should be directed towards the monster's head. It's the king of KOs for a reason, after all. You wouldn't expect a weapon like the hammer to be agile or have some finesse to it, but it actually does. On some of the moves, such as the uppercut and final level charge swing, you can actually use your clutch claw immediately after to grapple onto the monster. This is a fantastic way to grapple onto a monster after you finish your swings and need to get a little extra KO damage or weaken another part while it's moving around. This can be very easy to forget about if you don't do it for some time, but every time I pull it off, it gets more and more satisfying, especially if a KO results from the following grapple attack. Learn to use this wisely, and you'll have the monster parts weaken at your will. The hammer is a straightforward weapon. You don't have a complicated system of attacks. You don't have any ammo requirements. You just pick up the hammer and work towards knocking out the monster. Even though it has a straightforward usage and a straightforward goal to reach, there's so many ways to get there. So many ways to attack and nail the monster's head. Not to mention you can look pretty badass doing it. The hammers in World have been pretty satisfying to look at, and the latest edition of the Guild Palace hammer slash axe just adds to that. I have to give a special shout out to the Rajang and Zenogre hammers that light up beautifully when you charge them up. I'm not so much personally a fan of the meme weapons like the meat hammer, but you balance that out with beautiful weapons like the Guild Palace and even the space hammer. When you take up a weapon like the hammer, you don't just have to take the fight to the trenches, you can take it to the air as well. Having such a potent and damage-heavy attack like the spin attack on inclines gives you another great option to KO a monster, but also makes mounting ridiculously easy, and you'll notice in hunts just how many more times you end up doing it without even aiming to do so. Speaking of doing something many times, KOs with the hammers just start to rack up the more you use it and get used to the attacks that come with each level of charge. You have combos ready to go, single strikes like the uppercut, and each option has knockout potential. If you want to drop all of the mechanics, weapons with ammos you have to manage, song lists, etc., pick up the hammer and start smashing away for massive damage and knockouts. But that's going to be it for this one. The hammer is a weapon that I picked up a little late in the game, but is one I definitely enjoy. It has a lot of great weapon designs, and even a few with some fun added flair when you charge it up. When you want to just focus on doing damage and making solid contact with the monster's face, the hammer is the weapon you need to pick up. It may seem like a one-trick pony for that reason, but the amount of different ways you can do what it does best is pretty impressive. I have to apologize in the delay of the videos, but I've gotten some new equipment, so I've been trying to get that together and everything's finally ready to go. If you liked the video, please do let me know with a thumbs up. Comment down below what you think of the hammer, and if you're a hammer main, drop some advice you think might be useful. Subscribe if you haven't already for more Iceborne, Hunting Horn, and other Monster Hunter content. Dudes forever, have a good night, and happy hunting.